Good afternoon. Before the beginning of the new session, we have been very fortunate to have members from the foundation, Delhi World Foundation, to train our teachers. So we had a two-day workshop, very enriching, very innovative, and touching on the most vital areas of concerns. For example, language acquisition, bahut bahut important hai. How to communicate with parents, how to handle children, how to handle discipline, and on the current pedagogies and the changing trends in education. All this was addressed. It was activity-based workshop where all the teachers, even the new teachers who will be joining us, attended the workshop. This was organized by the foundation, and the educators were Dr. Radha and Ms. Harminder, who have been here with us for 2 days. And now this workshop is very important for us because it is whatever was discussed is implementable. And I'm sure our teachers, our students and the school is going to do very well with the valuable contribution that has been made, not only by the educators, but by all the teachers who attended it. Thank you.
Teachers ko counseling dena zaruri hota hai kyunki wo teachers parents ke saath interact karte hain aur bacche unke saath 5-6 ghante rehte hain to wo unko zyada wo dekh pate hain ki kya bachcha mein kya behavioral changes hai aur parents ke saath milke dono milke wo bacche ke liye wo bahut acha tarika dhoondte hain jaake taaki bachcha acha kar sake. तो इसलिए काउंसलिंग ज़रूरी है टीचर्स के लिए. उनको पता होता है कि पेरेंट्स के साथ बच्चों के साथ किस तरह का व्यवहार करना चाहिए, किस तरह उनकी प्रॉब्लम सुननी चाहिए. और बेसिकली तो हम बच्चे के लिए सब कुछ कर रहे हैं, तो जो भी हो पाता है टीचर्स से और स्कूल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन से, सब सब मिलके बच्चे के लिए बहुत कुछ करना चाहिए और करते भी हैं.
टीचर के लिए हमने क्या कहा था, पेशेंस और लिसनिंग. अब पेरेंट्स के लिए क्या गुरु मंत्र होगा, उनके लिए भी पेशेंस होगा, और बच्चों के लिए समय निकालिए अपने जो डेली रूटीन होता है उनको इग्नोर मत कीजिए. अब ज़्यादातर पेरेंट्स क्या करते हैं, मम्मी पापा दोनों नौकरी करते हैं तो बच्चा किसके बलबूते पलता है, काम वालियों के, क्रेशेस के, डे केयर, कहीं भी जाता है. ऐसे में जो बच्चा है उसको जो मम्मी पापा से प्यार मिलना चाहिए, अटेंशन मिलना चाहिए, जिसकी जैसे परवरिश होनी चाहिए, वो नहीं हो पाती है. तो ऐसे बच्चे जब स्कूल में आते हैं तो ज़रूर थोड़ा तंग करते हैं, बिकॉज उनकी एनरोलमेंट ऐसे नहीं हुई होती है, उनकी परवरिश कहीं थोड़ी कमी होती है. अब ना पेरेंट्स का क्या है, हाई प्रोफाइल पेरेंट्स होते हैं, वो उम्मीद करते हैं हमारा बच्चा एक उनके अपने प्लान के हिसाब से बच्चा चले, लेकिन क्या उस प्लान को साकार करने के लिए पेरेंट ने कोई मेहनत की, शायद नहीं की. अगर की होती ये नौबत नहीं आती जब बच्चा तंग करेगा. अगर नहीं की है ज़रूर बच्चा अटेंशन मांगेगा. बच्चा कह नहीं सकता आप मुझे वक्त नहीं दे रहे हो, क्या करेगा वो, ऐसे अटपटा बिहेवियर करेगा, गुस्सा दिखाएगा, नाराज़ होगा, किसी और की पिटाई करेगा. जो उसके अंदर जो गुस्सा है उसको निकालने के अजीब तरीके निकालेगा जो हमें ठीक नहीं लगता है. सो उसको ठीक करने के लिए फिर एक पेरेंट को, मम्मी को, पापा को, दोनों को वक्त देना ज़रूरी है. बच्चे को इग्नोर मत करिए, वक्त दीजिए, आई थिंक एवरीथिंग विल बी ऑल राइट.
अब दिल्ली वर्ल्ड पब्लिक स्कूल का दूसरा साल शुरू होने की तैयारियां हो रही हैं. 1 अप्रैल से हमारा जो दूसरा सेशन है वो स्टार्ट हो रहा है. कल हमारे सारे जो नए टीचर्स हैं उन्होंने भी स्कूल ज्वाइन कर लिया था, और बच्चों को बेस्ट एजुकेशन देने के लिए उनकी ट्रेनिंग बहुत ज़रूरी है. सो जो एजुकेशन बेस्ट पैडागॉजीज हैं, जो एजुकेशनल बेस्ट मेथोडोलॉजीज हैं, उनसे उनको वाकिफ कराने के लिए हमारे दो एजुकेशनल काउंसलर्स दिल्ली वर्ल्ड फाउंडेशन दिल्ली से आई थी. एक हैं डॉक्टर राधा सिंह, इनके पास ऑलमोस्ट 34 इयर्स का एक्सपीरियंस है. उन्होंने जो बेस्ट मेथोडोलॉजीज़ हैं और किस तरह से हमें उनको एक्चुलाइज करना है, मल्टीपल इंटेलिजेंस हैं उनको किस तरह से इन्हांस करना है, ये हमारे टीचर्स को सिखाया. और जो दूसरी हमारी काउंसलर आई थी उनका नाम है मिसेज हरमिंदर सिंह. और उन्होंने पेरेंट्स के साथ किस तरह से डील किया जाता है, और जो बच्चे थोड़ा स्ट्रगल कर रहे हैं जिनमें कुछ स्पेशल नीड्स हैं उनको किस तरह से एड्रेस किया जाता है, बहुत अच्छी तरह से हमारे पेरेंट्स टीचर्स को बताया। और मुझे पूरा विश्वास है कि आने वाला जो सत्र है वो हमारे लिए बहुत ही इफेक्टिव रहेगा इस ट्रेनिंग के बाद।
Would be going to any part of the world, they are the same. They are mostly agitated, they become very disturbed, and you need to calm them down. And what you say, it may not work. It may have adverse reactions. Because if you let someone wait, you know, the anger may boil up also. So what I would do, as many now as the academic team, or I was, what I was doing was, the first thing is to get a patient hearing to the parent, and we have the one-to-one interaction form. So the parent feels very important when his concern is being written down, and we are going to address it, we are going to find a solution, and we reassure the parent that whatever you have said is noted and we'll get back to you. They need to know. And there was very, when I was in Malaysia, there was something which was told to all of us. When parents come to the reception area, that place is the first their point where they meet anyone, receptionist. So they need to feel very welcome, first thing. Second thing is that somebody tells them, please wait for 10 minutes. The principal is busy, head is busy, please wait for 10 minutes. But you only make the parent wait for 5 minutes. And the parent feels very happy because he's, you know, called in before the time is out. And that works very well with the parents. But if you say 10 minutes and you make them wait 15 minutes, then they are boiling, they are fuming. So that's the best way to calm them down. I think that's
all. And a wonderful headmaster, he said, he did not say, he showed rather. Whenever a teacher used to come very agitated to the headmaster, he would make him sit down and pretend to be busy. Let me complete this and listen to you. Mm-hmm. And call the again, ma'am, the money belong. And it happened a few months back. So I said, sir, I'm a money belong.
Ceiling is a very minor crying when it comes to dealing with children is concerned. Headache is a very strong crying when it comes to dealing with children is concerned. They can go beyond stealing, beating, not studying. They can also put their life or the life of their peer around them in great danger. So you see, when we talk about knowledge, we become like a parent. And we can learn many things. And we can even learn to say Ram, Ram, Ram. But when the belief falls over us, then we start going we come to a novel. And that's the time where you are punishing a person. You are trying to be fair with a person. You have caught a person with a cigarette. You have caught a person who's totally drunk. You have met a person because of his extreme circumstances have become extremely violent and has become violent with the teachers. He's misbehaving with the teachers. Or she is going beyond the limits which are permissible. How do you deal with a parent? Because time has come that you have to suspend that child. Time has come when you have to take very strict action against the child. Where you might have been only involved as a person who takes the final decision. So that becomes a difficult proposition. Parent comes to you, sometimes very agitated. If it is a parent who has been on the receiving end, and sometimes parents come with humble requests because they could be in that level where we are making a decision where we are eradicating the child. In both the cases, what happens is that if you are not a person who learns this art of taking a decision, as Shubhra told us, your BP can cross those margins of 200, 120, 250. You have to drink water. You have to take others drink water. Relax. And then you understand that time is the best healer. Be patient. There are various virtues which we try to teach others. We have to practice ourselves. But yes, as far as our convictions are concerned, we should always stand tall. And we become the learners from a wonderful teacher called time. So, great experiences, I would not like to take personal examples. But then you learn every time with a new situation.